Well, it's all right. Riding around in the breeze. Well, it's all right. If you live the life you please. Well, it's all right. Doing the best you can. Well, it's all right. As long as you lend a hand.
You can sit around and wait for the phone to ring. Waiting for someone to tell you everything. Sit around and wonder what tomorrow will bring. Maybe a diamond ring.
Well, it's alright. Even if they say you're wrong. Well, it's alright. Sometimes you gotta be strong. Well, it's alright. As long as you got somewhere to lay.
This is Ray, and I wanted to tell a little story about Jamie Lyons, the Music Explosion, lead singer for the Music Explosion. And like a fool, I accidentally, yesterday, deleted Little Bit of Soul, removed it, and now I can't get it back, and just drives me crazy. But Jamie and I became friends, and Jamie had this magnetic personality about him, and I loved him first time I met him. And I remember once, before he was famous, he always was into music, but we went to this little club in this little small town in Ohio, Galleon, and he had wore his Mick Jagger. He kind of resembled Mick Jagger, but when he wanted to, he looked exactly like Mick Jagger, and they let him take the stage, and he just lip-synced, but he sang Rolling Stones music. And I mean, I'm talking about the, you know, marching across the stage like that. And I swear, the girls that were there, you would think that Mick Jagger was in front of them. That's how much power, charisma that he had. And I loved it. July 7th, 1967, Little Bit of Soul went to number one. It sold like 5 million copies. And so this was kind of like at the height of his popularity, this story. He had a big concert at a big arena in Indianapolis. And he decided to go with us. The rest of the band went in the van and stuff, and had a little red VW Bug. Belonged to my girlfriend at the time from California, Ba. And she hadn't cut her hair since she was like 5. So her hair was way down past her waist. I had an earring, long hair. There was Boxcar Bobby, 3-speed Bobby, long hair, and Jamie, of course, long hair, wild, crazy looking hair. And we pulled into this filling station somewhere between Galleon and Indianapolis. And we're just going to get some gas, you know. And when we pulled in, this pickup truck pulled in too. And it had like 4 guys squeezed in the front. Had the gun rack in the back. It was just like out of Deliverance. And man, did they come at us. They just like, I mean, you got to remember, this is like 1967. And wasn't always welcomed everywhere you went looking like that. And I thought there might be a fight because they were really coming strong. And we were just giving it back to them, you know. And it was getting heated, you know. We were laughing at them and stuff like that. And they were coming with all this ancient stuff like, man, are you a boy? Are you a girl? You know, really witty stuff like that, you know. And so we got back in the car and stuff. And they were taking off. Now, the exit out of this filling station onto the highway was narrow. It was just gravel. And on both sides was deep ditch, ravines. I mean deep. And the exit out was not very wide. And these guys were looking back, you know, doing this, yelling. And, you know, we just like waving at them and just irking them on. Well, the driver missed the exit. And they went straight into the ditch. I mean, up and down like this. I'm talking about the tail end of the truck was sticking almost straight up in the air. And you talk about rage. Man, these guys were so enraged because they blamed us. And so when we drove by them, I was driving. I just kind of slowed down. And, you know, we all said our little bit to them, you know, see you, honey, you know, and pulled out on the road because there was nothing that they could do. There was no way. They might still be there. And we went on to Indianapolis. And then I didn't see him again after we did that concert, which was a huge, huge success. And it was kind of cool hanging out with Jamie and I remember the drummer, Avery, I think was his name, was friends with him. And it was kind of cool hanging out, you know, with the star, like, because, you know, you the star, friend of a star, you know, so there was that thing going on. But then I went on back to California. I lost track of him and stuff like that. And then here in Cincinnati, in Hamilton, they had a big reunion. They had Gary Lewis and the Playboys and Johnny Rivers and the Ohio Players and Jerry Lewis. What was it? Jerry Lewis and the All-Stars or something like that, and the Playboys, something like that. And the Cascades. And Jamie knew that I lived in Cincinnati. And so he told a friend of mine, make sure you get Ray and get him to the concert. And so Sue and I went, and we got backstage, which is really just roped off and guarded by police, and saw him. And he had changed. He had changed a lot. But he still had that magnetic appeal. He was no longer that slim Mick Jagger guy, but he still had it, you know. And the one thing I remember from that was Johnny Rivers. Man, what a snob he was, because everybody else was friendly. The Cascades, everybody was really open and friendly, and there wasn't that many people allowed back there. But he pulled it in his limousine right behind stage and would not even roll the window down to say hi to anybody. So I'll never forget that. But when the concert was over, we said goodbye. And I'll always remember Jamie. He died of a heart attack at 57. About 4 or 5 years ago, I guess, something like that. And we had some great memories, some really great memories. Because we did a little, and I used to go over to Galleon all the time. And I found out later through a friend that would know that we were followed every time we went over there. And his sister didn't particularly like people going over there because she was a real protector of him. But God bless Jamie. And I'll never forget him. Or a little bit of soul. It's all right.
Well, it's all waiting for someone to tell you everything. Sit around and wonder what tomorrow will bring. Maybe a damn thing.
Well, it's all right, even if they say you're right.